position. Oh, what a nail! As Jonathan Bostic gets separated, Mike Willie from the football.
All right, you already know what time it is. It's fourth quarter boy sports. It is me, the illustrious one, Professor Lake, and we're back on a Victory Monday discussing the mouth shots that the Bears gave out to the Detroit Lions all day yesterday. So the Bears win 34-22. The score isn't indicative of how bad the Bears were slapping Lions around yesterday. All right, before we get into it, you know how I do right around this time. It's fourth quarter boy sports. I'm your illustrious host, Professor Lake. Like, comment, share, subscribe. Yeah, be a fourth quarter boy for life. Hit that notification bell. Let's jump right into this, all right? Mitch Trubisky, he comes through. He shows progression. He goes 23 of 30, 355 yards and 3 touchdown passes. He scrambles one in for himself. Then you got Allen Robinson. He caps the day off with 6 receptions for 133 yards and 2 touchdowns. One of these touchdowns went for 36 yards, the other one for 26 yards. Anthony Miller steps up to the plate. 5 receptions, 122 yards, 1 touchdown, a 45-yard touchdown at that. Tariq Cohen scats one in for a 1-yard touchdown. And then Mitchell Trubisky, he gets him a little touchdown running over linebacker Jared Davis, who is such a dirty player, but trying to push a quarterback while he's running out of bounds. Wow. If you showed that type of effort while we were playing in between the whistles, you might have had a better day, Jared. Talk my stuff a little bit. On the other side of the ball, leading the team with tackles, we got Roquan Smith with 10 tackles, 1 sack, 1 tackle for a loss. We got Bryce Callahan coming through with a pick and a sack. Prince Amukamara gets a pick, even though a lot of people think he should have just batted that one down and we could have took the field position around the 40, 43-yard line. Then we got Adrian Amos. He comes through with a fumble recovery as well. The defense was able to hold the Detroit Lions to 274 yards passing, 76 yards rushing. They were able to cause 3 turnovers. Khalil Mack had 2 sacks. Leonard Floyd had a sack, and he hit the quarterback 3 times. He's turning up, you guys. So when you look at the first drive, True shows a lot of aggressiveness. He also shows that he's comfortable back there operating in Matt Nagy's system. He played with conviction. One of the things I said that he was going to have to do more of earlier this season, I'm seeing it right now. And, you know, he kept the Lions off balance with this up-tempo offense. It seemed like as soon as the ball was placed, the Bears were on the line, ready to give it to the Lions and slap them around a little bit. When the defense was on the field, they had some up and downs during the second half of the game, but early on in the first half, you'll see a defense that showed a lot of aggressiveness, a lot of pressure. They were popping wide receivers as they came across the middle. Cleanly, of course. Yeah, this Bears defense is for real. Mack is back. He's causing pressure. He's making it a little bit easier for some of the other guys to get pressure as well, especially when you're an offensive coordinator. And you got to look out for a guy like Matt. You're going to send running backs at him. You're going to chip him with tight ends. You're going to do anything you can to slow him down. And that's only going to cause a lot of one-on-ones on the other side of the line when you got a guy like Akeem Hicks, Eddie Goldman, Bilal Nichols rotating in there, Leonard Floyd on the other side, Aaron Lynch. I mean, we're coming full force at every single quarterback. You need to get rid of the ball quickly. That's all you can do against the Bears. If you're going to hold the ball and try to go downfield against the Bears, you're putting your quarterback in danger, and you might need to get fired because it's just not the game plan you need to have. Get the ball out quick. You're not going to be able to dominate our defense. You're going to have to wait for us to mess up before you get an opportunity to score. And that's just how it's going to be from now on. It's a new day in Chicago. So for all you little Detroit Lion fans who thought you were going to come here to Detroit and you know, have Matt Stafford just sit back in the pocket and pick us apart, those days are over. We exposed Matt Stafford yesterday, and he was exposed the game before that. You guys got a lot of work to do, okay? Second time the offense gets the ball, the running game could have been better. But hey, when you got a guy like Allen Robinson on your squad, he's going to pick up a lot of yards for you. You know, you get a big game by Allen Robinson. They run a couple more plays. Ben Broniker makes a nice little catch on the right side of the field. And then you got Allen Robinson. You just hit him in the end zone, and he does his thing. You know, so Allen Robinson gets his touchdown on the second offensive possession. The defense, the swarming, the Detroit Lions. At this point, they get a big third down stop, stuffing the run. You know, they just really demoralize their offense, and they slap around the defense. Trubisky does not let off the gas. Again, he comes back on the field, moving the offense. And then he hits Anthony Miller for a touchdown. Anthony Miller showing you guys how you get yak. He's drinking a lot of it, fellas. I mean, what more can you ask for out this wide receiving core? The guys that we knew were going to step up, stepped up to the plate, and they dominated yesterday. Anthony Miller gets a 100-plus yard game, and so does Allen Robinson. And that's what you need out of these guys on the outside to help Mitchell Trubisky out. True was accurate with the downfield pass as well. All I see is more and more improvement going forward into the season. So after Bryce Callahan interception, Mitchell Trubisky comes back on the field, leads the offense once again. This time he's leading them with his legs. He's doing a little bit of scrambling. He's making a lot of guys look crazy out there trying to catch up with him. So bad that Jared Davis wants to commit a punt penalty and pushing our quarterback out of bounds. Shame on you. But Mitchell Trubisky, he keeps his calm. He stays collected. He continues to move this offense, and he knows that he'll have an opportunity to get back at Jared Davis for trying to injure him on the sideline. And what does he do? He does a quarterback draw behind Jordan Howard, running over Jared Davis and getting his touchdown on the ground. Beautiful. Now, when the defense comes on the field, I know a lot of guys felt that Matt Nagy should challenge the call on the field that the player was down, because that was a fumble. Kyle Fuller rocked the wide receiver coming across the middle. They didn't even want to catch the ball that game, honestly, man. The way the cornerbacks were hitting, the way they were tackling this game, they just took the hearts out of these wide receivers. So Kyle Fuller rocks this guy. He drops the ball. He fumbles. The referee says he's down by contact. Hey, whatever. Matt Nagy was late on throwing the flag. Cool. The only problem is they end up driving down the field and getting a touchdown. But hey, so after that, you know, we run a couple plays. We go into halftime. We come back out on the field. And, you know, we give up a field goal, 52-yard field goal. So we weren't allowing the team to get deep in our territory. So that's a plus as far as I'm concerned. But when we get the ball back on offense and Amil catches a bomb putting you in scoring range, whether it be in the red zone for a touchdown or getting in field goal range, Cody Parkey needs to be able to hit these field goals. You know, later on in the season, we're going to be playing some teams where we're just not going to be able to blow them out like we're doing the sorry Detroit Lions right now. We're going to need our field goal kicker to give us those extra points to edge out some of these close matchups. Now, I know we're so much better than Detroit that it didn't matter this game, but like I said before, later on in the season, when we're playing teams with better records and more to play for, we're going to need our kicker to be more solid, and that's just that. I talked to a lot of people that said that we should cut Cody Parkey, that he shouldn't be in Chicago another week. But I have to say this, Matt Nagy is a consummate professional. This shows his patience with players as well to get themselves back on track. And I think that tempered a lot of anger amongst Chicago Bear fans who are tired of Cody Parkey missing game-winning field goals, missing chip shots. And this has been a consistent pattern. When he feels that he's under pressure or any situation. Some of these situations are not even pressure situations. You have to make these field goals, Parkey. All right, I'm not going to beat a dead horse. I'll move on. But that was disappointing. Two missed extra points, two missed field goals, all hitting the upright. I mean, come on, man. Come on. But that's not going to hurt the Bears this game. No, no, no. The Bears were who we thought they were. The Bears went out there, they dominated on defense, they dominated on offense, and Kerryon Johnson, if it wasn't for late in the fourth quarter, they wouldn't have had that many rushing yards. So after this missed field goal, the Bears defense shows up again, causing Kerryon Johnson to fumble, recovered by Adrian Amos. the wily veteran, I guess you could say, right around now. The defense has just been stepping up to the plate. They've been giving our offense so many opportunities to dominate. I just like seeing these guys on the field because I know they're going to play aggressively. I know somebody's about to get hit, a sack, an interception, a fumble. You know, you can bet money on it. They're going to get multiple turnovers every game. Unfortunately, when we get the ball back, we get in field goal range, and Cody Parkey misses another field goal. The defense holds. We get the ball back. We end up getting our first punt of the day on our eighth drive of the game. The Bears' offense was incredible. Mitchell Trubisky was incredible. These wide receivers were incredible today. We had eight drives where we didn't punt the ball. We got points for the most part, if it wasn't for Cody Parkey. Floyd gets a quarterback hit to end the drive. Floyd was in the mix today. You know what I mean? Allen Robinson doubles back with a touchdown. Trey Burton gets a two-point conversion. Matt gets a sack. Prince gets a pick. And everything after that was prevent, just trying to get out of there safely. So it was a great overall victory for the whole team. Cody Parkey has to get better. No doubt about that. But when in the last 10 years have you been able to say something like this about the Chicago Bears? I'm not worried about their offense. I'm not worried about their defense at this point. I'm worried about a kicker. The Bears haven't had a prolific offense in a long time. It feels good. It looks good to see these guys come out there and find some open receivers, scheme some guys open. Just being able to pass so effectively. It's so different as a Bears fan. When you're used to having people say that the Bears are a running team and they play good defense, well, now we play great offense and we play great defense and not so great special teams, but that's coming along. That is going to happen. Again, my overall opinion about the success of the Bears, I just see True getting better and better, and he showed it against a divisional opponent yesterday. Just having control, conviction, accuracy, all rolled up in one ball. He showed out against the Detroit Lions defense that I think people were kind of overrating, seeing that they beat the Packers and they beat the New England Patriots. I just don't know what's going on with their team. I'm not sure if their coaching move was beneficial for them at this point, because offensively and defensively, they don't look good. And they really look like they've taken a big step back from last year. With that in mind, when we're talking about the Bears, we're looking at a team that's trying to make a statement in the division. This is just the beginning, as Allen Robinson said. They have a long road ahead of them. So, you know, really the Bears did a great job, both sides of the ball. Special teams could have been better. Mitch showed progression, comfort, conviction in his throws, accuracy. The receiver stepped up. The offensive line had great protection. The defensive front was getting pressure on the quarterback all day. I know that after this game, the Detroit Lions fans, they were probably crying. They were probably crying. They probably cut their TVs off at halftime because they knew the ass kicking that the Bears were giving their team was something that they couldn't come back from. So this goes out to Don Burr. He's a guy that likes to leave nasty comments on the bottom of different Bears podcasts. I'm sure a couple people have blocked him. He talked a lot of trash during this offseason. He's real quiet right now. I'm sure he's crying right now. And I like to call him Senior Rita Purr. With all of that in mind, man, you know, we stomped the life out the Lions this week. We ripped the hearts out their fans. We made the coach look really gullible and stupid. And hey, what can I say, man? I'm a fan as well. I had to dish a little bit of this out because, you know, Lions fans, they're a little distasteful. They don't know when to stop while they're ahead. You saw one of the Lions players get a cheap shot on our guy, Tariq Cohen, and told him to get his ass off the field. While you're sitting there down 24-10, you're a cornerback, a safety, I don't know who you are, and you can't cover anybody. You already let go 355 yards passing and three touchdowns, and you're worried about getting Tariq Cohen off the field, huh? Why don't you go cover somebody, buddy? This goes out to you, Don Burr. With that in mind, it's Fourth Quarter Boys Sports. I'm your illustrious host, Professor Lake. in the building, man. Slide on me, dog. Fourth Quarter Boyz Sports. Like, comment, share, subscribe. Be a Fourth Quarter Boyz for life, man. For life, man. Hit that notification bell. You already know it's popping. I'm going to check in with y'all a little bit later, but man, you know, I really enjoyed the Bears feasting on the carcass of the Detroit Lions. The Chicago Bears did that. So all you Detroit Lions fans, you hold this L. Hold that L, and we'll see you on Thanksgiving dinner. All right? I'm out.
And it's a throw. Jonathan Bostic just separated Mike Willie from the football.